Hey there, YouTubers. It's your good friend here, Team RI, host with the most, and we are gonna do the 2015 Money in the Bank live from Columbus, Ohio. Okay, my friend, introduce yourself, plug your social media, and all that great stuff.
What's up, guys? My name is Neil on the DB, and we're gonna be, as you said, we're gonna be reviewing 2015 Money in the Bank from Columbus, Ohio. Pretty average show. Follow me on Instagram, Darian underscore Velasquez. Add me on Facebook, Darian Velasquez, all that shit. So let's get going.
Okay, the first match was the pre-show. What's your overall thoughts on the pre-show match, my friend?
Well, I mean, I enjoyed the match, honestly. But it's just stupid how they keep trying to put R-Truth in everything.
Yeah, I know. And another thing is, he won a damn match. It should be King Barrett. So what's up with that, you know?
I don't know. They keep trying to push R-Truth, even though he's not going to go anywhere.
No, I mean, he should have. I mean, he'd been coming longer than Barrett, but that's WWE's fault. They pushed him a while back in 2011, and look what happened. It didn't go nowhere, you know?
Yeah.
And that's pathetic, but whatever. Okay, now the first match to kick off the Money in the Bank pay-per-view was the ladder match, briefcase match. And go ahead, tell all the viewers who's in that match, if they don't know by now.
Neville, Sheamus, Randy Orton, and, what's his name? Damn it, I forgot. What's his name? King and Kofi Kingston.
Yes. Yeah. What's your thoughts on this overall match? Do you really enjoy it to kick off the pay-per-view, or you prefer another match to kick off the show?
Very quick, I could say. I mean, it's longer than, it's shorter than, you know, all the other matches they've had. Money in the Bank.
Yeah.
It was pretty short. I mean, I don't know why they let Sheamus win.
Like, me neither.
Really don't. Like, why would you have Sheamus win? You know, they just brought him back as a heel. He's not going to go anywhere.
Nope.
So, I don't know why they keep trying to push him.
Stupid. I think that was bad for business. Now, I'm not too sure if you heard that. People on Twitter thought Kofi is going to win it, and I thought he's going to win it. Thank God he didn't, because no reason, because next month, he puts a face Brock Lesnar at the 4th of July special thing on the network. Did you hear about that?
Yeah.
Do you think that's really... I mean, if that did happen, I mean, Kofi, do you think he's going to face Brock Lesnar? I mean, it's going to happen eventually, but, I mean, were you picking Kofi to win or not really?
I mean, I had hopes that I was thinking Roman Reigns was going to win.
Okay.
I mean, just because they've been pushing him, like, this whole time.
Yeah.
So, yeah, but that didn't end up happening. And I was pissed off, actually, that Sheamus won. Because I'm just like, what is Sheamus doing winning stuff? Like, he hasn't won a championship since, like, 2012.
Yeah, and 2010 also, you know?
Yeah.
But before that, why in the hell is... Bray Wyatt in the Fiora match.
They're trying to start this feud. Like, why did they do the whole... They did the whole Ryback and Wyatt feud.
Yeah.
Which lasted, like, 2 weeks.
It sucked.
And then, yeah, and then they're doing this, like, Roman Reigns, Bray Wyatt feud. I don't... Why? Like, Roman Reigns is so irrelevant that they have to put him against Bray Wyatt, then he should just get fired or just go away. Like, they tried pushing him, and it didn't work. So why are you pushing him again?
Who's that?
I don't know.
Bray Wyatt?
Yeah, Bray Wyatt. Like,
I like Bray Wyatt, but I think they should turn him face. Give that a chance, you know?
Yeah.
But I guarantee you, down the road, I think Roman Reigns is going to turn heel, because all these chances, he's getting close, he's getting fed up, and one day he's going to turn on the fans, you know? That's just my theory, and I just have a feeling he's going to get screwed, and I was correct, but I just don't like how it ended, but whatever, but I prefer a young guy. I really want Neville to win it, because he won a ladder match at NXT, but whatever, you know?
Yeah.
But what's the next match? Go ahead.
The next match was, I think, Divas match. Yeah.
You know what? That match was not that bad. The ending was dog shit. Once again, they used twin magic and freaking bullshit. And the only reason they want Nikki bailout to retain because they want to be AJ's Rooker, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, that's just my theory. Do you think I'm right or do you think I'm making this shit up?
Well, see, they have to find someone who's going to replace AJ Lee.
Yeah.
Nikki Bella's not that person. She really isn't. Like, she has, okay, she has a bigger rack than AJ Lee.
Yeah, that's true.
She just, I don't think she fits the mold of, like, AJ Lee, because AJ Lee was this, like, crazy, you know, out of line, like,
yeah.
Basically, she was kind of like a heel and a face at the same time. Like, you couldn't hate her, but you couldn't like her either.
Yeah.
I don't really think there's, like, any person that could really replace her. But, I mean, there's certain people that can, you know, do better than her, but, like, they're just not giving them pushes. Like, hey, I used to think that, like, Paige, okay, she's going to go somewhere. She won the championship at WrestleMania, after WrestleMania 30, and all of a sudden, she wins the championship, gets taken away, and Nikki Bella just goes on this, you know, run with the championship that's lasting way too long.
Yeah, but don't get me wrong. Nikki and Brie, they came a long way in the business, but I think it's time she can drop the belt. If she don't lose the belt at Battleground or SummerSlam, I guarantee you she's going to lose it at September 9th at Champions, my friend.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just my thoughts. Overall, what's your thoughts on this match? You like it, dislike it, or you could care less about this match?
I liked it, actually. I really enjoyed it. It's just that I wanted Paige to win, honestly. I just want Nikki Bella without the championship.
Yeah, it was a good match, but the ending kind of was, it was not good at all. The ending kind of sucks, but whatever. But Paige will get her match once, probably probably down the road. But what's the next match?
Right, we had the Intercontinental Championship match, Ryback and Big Show.
That was a very, very slow match. I didn't care for it at all. I said, okay, whatever. I was just on Twitter or watching other things. So whatever. Yeah.
Why the fuck is Big Show still on the WWE?
Yeah.
He should why?
He should just be... You know why? Because probably he still have a contract. So they got to use him.
Well, yeah, remember he had that Ironclad contract.
Yeah, but that, you know what? They just don't discuss it anymore.
Yeah. Big Show hasn't been relevant since like 2009. He had that feud with Edge and Cena.
I love that feud. That was a good feud.
Yeah. That's the only... Basically, the only time he's ever been loved.
Well, he needs a job. Like everybody else, he needs to stay backstage. I thought he's part of the authorities. What happened? The authorities just kicked him out?
Yeah.
They did? They don't even use him anymore. He was part of the authorities, wasn't he?
Yeah, for like a little bit. Until he became face again.
Oh, that's why it happened, see?
Yeah, then he went heel, and now he's heel.
See, they can't make their minds up, you know? But he needs to retire. Kane needs to retire. But Kane's not going to retire for a long time because he still got a contract and then probably eventually be a legend contract. But that match is dog shit. Just hopefully they don't have a rematch at Battleground because I think one match is good enough for Big Show versus Ryback for the belt, you know? And it was not a, Big Show won, but he won on disqualification, right?
Yeah.
See? Dumb. We don't never should see that at pay-per-view-wise. If we pay good money, I know it's $9.99, or if you get the pay-per-view for free, but whatever. But what's the next match, man?
Yeah, Tag Team Championship match, New Day versus Primetime Players.
Now, overall, I was very surprised that Primetime Players lost. I mean, I'm sorry, won. Were you shocked they won the belts?
Honestly, no.
No?
I actually wanted them to win the belts. I hate New Day. I really did.
I think everybody hates him. Is it because they push him too quickly, or what was the problem?
This whole positivity thing is so stupid because it's been done before.
By who?
It's been done before by, like, Dude Love. Always positive. Basically, it's like a face turned up to 11.
Okay.
So I don't know why, like, they keep pushing these people. Like, no one's getting over with them. Like, no one's liking them. So why do they keep pushing these people to, you know?
Do you like Kofi on their own, and you like these guys on their own, or you prefer a team?
I'd rather have Kofi on his own than with a group because he's just not good.
No, he's not. I mean, you know, it's great he's getting this push, but not this kind of push we want. You know. I don't know. Can you imagine if he won Money in the Bank? That'd be a nightmare, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, that'd be
no,
great because.
Yeah, I'm glad the Pride Guys won because they brought some legitimacy back to the championship.
Yeah, but how long is it gonna keep the belts? Because you never know, they might drop the belts in the fall. You know, that's how WWE is. They don't give a damn about the mid card belts. They only give a darn about the main event belt.
I guarantee you, at Battleground, New Day's gonna win it back.
Yeah, I they will, or maybe September they will.
Yeah.
But let's. I mean, I really enjoy this match. It was kind of very fast for some reason. They just not enough time. They want all the time for the main event, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. Take it away again.
We had Cena and Owens next.
Yeah, it's the rematch from a Chamber, and I think this is a better match than the first time they met. You agree?
Yeah, definitely.
Awesome match. A lot of people see on Twitter the match of the year right now, but the year's not over yet. But I give the fans, I give the two wrestling fans, I mean, the Owens and John Cena, two thumbs up, hands down. I love the match, but the outcome, you had a feeling that's going to happen because Owens was not a very happy camper because he lost.
Yeah.
What's your thoughts on the overall match?
Love this match.
Any spots you really love? Any of the holy shit moments on this match?
I like the part where Kevin Owens stole the Cut Knuckle Show.
Oh yeah, that was great. And do you like how John Cena did like the stunner kind of thing, or do you like you hate when he did that?
I don't like it. He's not a high flying superstar, so when he just starts doing that, it just looks so awkward.
Yeah.
It's like it's not good. I just wish that Kevin Owens isn't like less. I don't want to say less cocky because that's just how his character is, but like less of a loudmouth.
Well,
I don't know if that makes sense.
Yes, is he? And then, do you think I guarantee they're going to have a match at Battleground because they announced it tonight. But they will. This feud's not over with a long shot, but I think this will be the last match, hopefully.
Yeah. Like, I don't want it to do like a Cena and Rusev and just go on for like 4 days.
I mentioned before in my other videos that feud sucked. I was at WrestleMania 20, 31. That match sucked. Extreme Rules, that match sucked, but overall, the feud just sucks, but, what am I gonna say, I think Kevin Owens need to win this feud.
Yeah. I mean, if they want Kevin Owens to be pushed, then he needs to win this feud.
Yes.
They just can't have John Cena win every single time.
No, he does not. Okay, what's the next match?
So, next match, I think we had a championship match, Strong's and Ambrose.
Yeah, the main event, these two guys been bickering for a while. WWE renewed their feud, ever since what happened the last pay-per-view. I had a feeling because it was a pathetic finish. I really like this match. I thought Dean Ambrose was going to win, how it ended. It was weird. It reminded me of No Mercy of, 2008 when Y2J and Shawn Michaels. You remember that time? Remember that match?
One of my favorite matches of all time.
It was great. You know, two guys are holding on to the belt, and it came out of HBK's hand, and it went to Y2J's hand. And it really got to my stomach, and WWE should do that more often, but that's not going to happen. Seth Rollins retains without the authorities, without JG security, without nobody. He should do that more often, but that's not going to happen. And I really thought that Brock Lesnar is going to make a shocking appearance.
He hated this ending.
It was
I wish they would have just brought the titles down at the same time, restarted the match, and just like, you know, let's fight it out. You know, see who the real winner is.
Or both guys came down. Would they have a co-winners, or do you think that would be stupid?
I would have liked the co-winners because it's not the same. It's like Seth Rollins winning everything. I don't like championship reigns. And just have the champion winning everything. Like, winning every single match he's in.
Yep.
Just by, like, either dirty tactics or just winning fans. But
I don't like how he's using Triple H's move. I prefer using the curse stomp, but they banned it because they said head injuries, you know?
Well, tell that to the pile driver.
I don't know. You know how WWE is. Maybe one day they might change that, his old finishing move, but you watch. don't know if you watched the video, but when he went to a Comic-Con, and he said, is that true about his, Q&A? And he said, yep, that's true, until further notice. So he's got to use his, they got to use Triple H's move, so that's stupid, you know?
Yeah.
But whatever. Overall, on this pay-per-view, you like it, dislike it, or you could care less about this pay-per-view?
I'd give it a 3 out of 5.
I'd give a 3 out of probably 6.
Yeah. 3 out of 5 because it had really good matches. The matches were good.
Yeah, the only matches that are really good, the first briefcase, you know, the kick off the show, Kevin Owens and John Cena, great match, and the main event was great. The other matches were so-so. What about you? What match what really stands out?
Rollins and Ambrose. Like, that's hands down best match on the card. I don't care what anyone says, best match on the card. Seth Rollins, Dean Ambrose, they went out there, they kicked butt. Holy shit. When you get a holy shit chant in the PG era, you know you did something right.
Oh, yeah. But I guarantee you that when the DVD comes out, they're going to try to edit it out. The holy shit part.
Yeah, they did edit out some parts on the broadcast that I saw. There was, it was edited because I guess, in the pain, they just started cursing. I don't know.
But,
I wish there was less censorship in the WWE.
Oh, what?
Or at least more bad words. Like, bad words are not going to hurt anyone. So, I mean, at least just, say shit once in a while.
I know. Come on now. Especially for pay-per-views, for crying out loud. I know there's pay-per-view free, and probably next pay-per-view will be free. Probably all pay-per-views will be free until SummerSlam, you know?
Yeah. So one thing I want to say is that I really don't like the way the WWE is going right now. I mean, seems like every single pay-per-view is just a glorified Raw. Like, if Raw went, 4 hours, this would be it.
Yeah. Do you think, I don't think Seth Rollins needs JJ Security. He don't need authority. He don't need King. He don't need nobody no more. But we all know that tomorrow night on Raw, they all gonna celebrate and all that bull stuff, you know?
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I will never pay for this pay-per-view because it's not that good. It was not really that worth ordering, you know?
Yeah, I'm not getting the DVD.
You're not gonna buy the DVD?
Nope.
I don't buy the DVD anyway because they don't do a good job on these covers, but they just get so lazy.
Yeah.
That's why I got the network.
Go ahead.
In the network, last pay-per-view, I had a lot of lag in this pay-per-view. No lag at all, so that is great news. Maybe because a lot of people don't want to watch this pay-per-view tonight. Maybe.
Yeah, I don't like the way the pay-per-views are done. Like, go back to the times where you had amazing matches and not just filler matches. Like, R-Truth and King Barrett Right Back and Show were all filler matches. No one really cared.
Nope. I prefer, R-Truth versus King Barrett, I prefer an interview, The Miz interview, Daniel Bryan, or something like that. I don't want to see a stupid match every time they have a pre-show, you know? It's stupid.
Yeah.
But, whatever.
I wish they would just go over every single match. Go over, the promo, why it happened.
Yeah.
You know, stuff like that.
Yep. Let me see here. How long do you think Paige will still be in a title picture for a while?
For a while. I think she's not getting the push, but she's gonna be the next big thing. Like, honestly. She will.
Yeah. But I heard not tomorrow, but the following Monday, Lesnar is going to come back. Is that true or rumor?
No, it's true. It's been confirmed. Yeah.
So he's going to have a match at Battlegrounds, huh?
I hope.
So he's supposed to be back early this year. Usually he's supposed to be back August. Now they change it to June, huh?
Yeah. I still think he's going to have a match with SummerSlam. If he doesn't have a match at Battleground or... Yeah, if he doesn't have a match at Battleground, then he'll have a match at SummerSlam.
Well, he will. If you don't have a Battleground, it's automatically SummerSlam because he wants to face Seth Rollins for the belt. Yeah,
Yeah, how do you feel about the whole like gap between pay-per-views? Like they did what was it? Payback? And then they did They did Elimination Chamber and then 2 weeks after that they did Money in the Bank. How do you like that? Do you like it or no?
It's good, but no build up that much, you know?
Yeah, I mean
Then plus you have NXT pay-per-view, I mean that doesn't come, but still, three pay-per-views in a month of, what is it, May or June?
Yeah. I think they had three pay-per-views in the month of May.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Two or something like that.
That's crazy.
Yeah, I think two pay-per-views in it, like, the Taboo Tuesdays and the Cyber Sundays used to do, which was fine, that they did it in 1 month, but or they did two in 1 month, but like now it's just not, like, no. We don't want two pay-per-views in a month. One month of a bad pay-per-view is fine.
Yeah.
Another month of a bad pay-per-view is not. You know, not. Another bad pay-per-view is not fine in 1 month. It's not.
But, I don't know. It's all mixed the money. But, that's all I'm going to say here. You know, it's from live from Columbus, Ohio. I've been watching. I have finished. It don't matter now. I got marathon of the Money in the Bank, so I really enjoy that. Yeah, I know Rollins is pissed because he got screwed again. I really want to see Neville win it or some other superstars. What about you?
Yeah, I'd like to see Neville win. Yeah. And other superstars, don't you fill the matches anymore. Just make these matches mean something.
Yeah, they always do that. They always concentrate on main event, then like the mid carders, then other matches. It's all filler.
Yeah.
I think that's our review. So what do you give this review? What do you give this review then?
I give it a 3 out of 5.
Okay, and then sure. I give it a 3 out of 6. So it's okay, but so I'm on here to host the most tomorrow. You can follow me on Twitter, TMRI32, and go ahead and plug your social media again.
Yeah, so that'll do it for our review. Make sure to tune in for a Raw review tomorrow. Same time, basically, 11 o'clock, Raw review. It's going to be an awesome show. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Darian _ Velasquez. Follow me on Facebook, all that shit. So if you guys enjoyed this, you know what to do. And peace out.
Yeah, have a good night. And a tag team champion's out here. And see you guys and ladies next podcast edition. Peace out.